ready to do the greeting all together. It is the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Listening, God, we often find ourselves swept up in the business of the day. Like a seesaw of the faithfulness, we move back and forth, up and down, constantly trying to find you in the midst of it all. So speak clearly to us now. Quiet the distractions long enough for us to affix ourselves to our good news. We are listening, we are hungry, we are hopeful. Amen.
You may be seated.
We are going to start with a story. And so if you want to see the story, you can move closer. Maybe sit in the aisle if you can't see it where you're at. But otherwise, I'll hang out up here so you can see it. Sorry, Melissa. This is called That's Not How You Do It. Lucy knew how to do everything. I sure do. She knew how to eat with a spoon and a fork. She knew how to play the xylophone. Do any of you have xylophones at home? No? Your mom and dad haven't been brave enough to do that yet. Lucy knew how to do gymnastics and how to build a tall tower. Do you build towers at home? Sometimes, yeah. She knew how to paint an elephant and how to fold perfect stars. In fact, if you didn't know how to do something, you came to Lucy for help. Do you see all of the people she's helping? She's helping someone with a kite, helping someone tell time on the clock, helping someone peel their banana. Do you ever need help with that? I do. Everything was fine until the day Toshi arrived. You see what kind of animal Toshi is? Yeah. A panda bear. Yeah. And Toshi's suitcase says, far away. Toshi is from far away. Toshi did not know how to eat with a spoon and a fork. What's he using? Can you see? Chopsticks. She's thinking, that's not how you do it. You use a fork and a spoon, right? Toshi's music was strange. She's playing an instrument that she doesn't recognize. And she says, that's not how you do it. Toshi's gymnastics were all wrong. What's he doing? Can you tell? He's doing yoga. She says, that's not gymnastics. That's not how you do it. And his tower wasn't half as good as Lucy's. She says, that's not how you do it. He didn't know how to draw an elephant like she did. That's not how you do it. And when he started to make a paper star that was all wrong, Lucy couldn't keep quiet any longer. You see her tail? What happens to cats when they get angry or scared? Their tail goes poof. And she screamed, that's not how you do it! And Toshi said, hey, Lucy, this is for you. And she handed her this little paper figure. And she is scratching her head going, what is this? She says, this is lovely, Tashi, but what is it? It's a paper queen. Will you show me how to make one? She asked him. And he said, yes. And will you show me how to make a star like yours? And so what do you see them doing here? On this page. Are they teaching each other how to fold those shapes? Yeah. They had so much fun that they made a whole flock of paper cranes and a night sky full of paper stars. The end. Look at all those cranes and stars. So, what happened in that book? What happened in that story? Did Lucy have a lot of things that she said, this is the one way to do it and that is the only way? Yeah. But then she met someone who did things a little differently, right? And at first, she was really upset because she saw all of these things that he was doing and thought, that's not how I do it. That's not what I had in mind, so therefore it is wrong. But then what did she learn? That he had things to teach her too. Yeah. That they had things that they could do together, and that just because he did something differently didn't mean that it was wrong. So, in our gospel story today, in our story of Peter and Jesus, Peter thinks that he knows the best way to do everything, just like Lucy does in this book. And so, we are going to read another story together. And this time, I'm going to need your help telling the story. There's a couple places where I'm going to pause and say, do what I do. All right? So, the Gospel according to Matthew. It's going to be different than what you see in your bulletin, so just heads up. Once the disciples all knew that Jesus was the Messiah, Jesus started to teach them what that meant. That he would have to go to Jerusalem, the capital city, where the leaders there would be very angry with him. Can you make an angry face?
Oh, that's good.
Just like Lucy's face, right? Jesus told Peter that he would be killed in Jerusalem, but that he would be raised from the dead on the third day. But Peter heard that, and he said, I don't like the sound of that. That is not what I meant when I said that you are the Messiah. And so Peter took Jesus aside. I'm going to come back here to make the microphone a little happier. Peter took Jesus aside and scolded Jesus, saying, absolutely not. It cannot happen that way, and I will not let it. Can you wag your finger? But Jesus told Peter, get out of my way. You are trying to tempt me away from the path that I must take. I'm seeing God's big picture, but you are only worried about what's here on earth. All right. So we have this story where Peter hears Jesus explain what it means for Jesus to be the Messiah. And Peter goes, no. That's not what I meant when I said that you're the Messiah. I did not say that you need to die. And Jesus said, well, I'm gonna have to, but I'll be raised again. But Peter is just so upset by this. It is not what he had in mind. So what do you think about Peter's response when he learned about Jesus' death? Was he trying to be brave and save his friend? Was he maybe scared that he would be killed too? Or did he have other ideas about what the Messiah was supposed to do? How do you think Peter felt at the end of this story? How do you think Peter felt after scolding Jesus and being scolded right back? How do you feel when you get scolded? When you get called out for doing something wrong? This is open to everybody. Roy.
Bad.
Doesn't feel great, right? But sometimes it's necessary. Yeah. What do you think Peter's next move might have been after Jesus told him to get out of his way? This isn't looking for an actual correct answer of what Peter did next, but what do you think Peter might have done after Jesus said, get out of my way?
Apologized.
Yeah. Might have apologized and then, like, really gotten out of the way and said, well, then I guess I'm out. I guess I'll just be over here being quiet because I can't do anything right. That's probably what I would do. Are there times in your life that you would prefer to do things one way, but someone tells you that they need to be done a different way? Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
Uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable.
Change is hard.
Change is hard. Sometimes my logical and emotional self argue with each other over it. Because logically, I might know that something needs to be done a different way and that it's not my way or the highway. But sometimes I would really prefer for that to be true, right? Yeah. I was telling Melissa last week at church that my piano teachers, when I was growing up, really wanted me to practice my hands separately for piano and practice one hand at a time. And I hated that. I refused. I said, but then I learned them separately and I can't put them back together again. And they argued and argued and argued with me over it. They were right. Sometimes people speak truth to us that is hard to hear. Sometimes in pretty inconsequential moments, like learning how to play piano, and sometimes this big moment, like with Peter, in preparing the way for the kingdom of heaven, right? And Peter and Jesus are both pretty stubborn in this story. They are both set, and this is how it's going to be. And sometimes being stubborn is a good thing. And sometimes it's a bad thing. And sometimes it's kind of in the middle. And it depends on which side you're on, or whether you're able to see both sides at the same time. There's no right wrong for who's more stubborn here. There's no right answer. Sometimes we are stubborn. Sometimes we are unable to see what God has planned for us versus what we have planned for us, because sometimes those things don't match up. And it can be really hard to see that. It can be really hard when Jesus is very truthful about it. There is always a bigger picture in mind when it comes to God. Always a sight on the bigger picture for all people. So will you pray with me? Repeat after me. Dear God.
Dear God.
We know we can be stubborn.
We
like to do things the way we want to do them.
We like to do things the way we want to do them.
But your way is the best way.
But your way is the best way.
Help us to be brave.
Help us to be brave.
And follow Jesus even when it's hard.
Follow Jesus even when it's hard.
Amen. We are going to sing a song called The Way, and this one is printed in your bulletin. This is one that was written for our theme that we are in. So this song, The Way, is all about learning how to follow Jesus and get out of our own way so that we can follow.
It's a familiar tune, just different words.
It is a familiar
words,
tune.
So.
During our prayers this morning, there will be a few points where I pause and ask for you to share your thanksgivings and your concerns. So I invite you to be prepared for that. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Mighty God of mercy, we thank you for the resurrection dawn, bringing the glory of our risen Lord who makes every day new. Especially we thank you for the sustaining goodness of your creation, for the new creation in Christ and all gifts of healing and forgiveness, for the gifts of relationship with others, for the communion of faith in your church. People of God, for what else do we give thanks? For our grandchildren.
This congregation.
This congregation.
For help.
For help. And health.
Health.
for music. For robins. For pets.
Children.
For children. For our confirmation students.
For peace.
For peace. And for our Sunday schoolers. For all the leaders of our congregation, the creativity and vitality that they bring to this place. Merciful God of might, renew this weary world. Heal the hurts of all your children and bring about your peace for all in Christ Jesus, the living Lord. Especially we pray for those who govern nations of the world, for the people in countries ravaged by strife or warfare, for all who work for peace and international harmony, for all who strive to save the earth from carelessness and destruction, for the Church of Jesus Christ in every land. For what else do we pray?
Sunshine.
For sunshine.
Rain.
For rain.
For first responders.
For first responders. For all who were impacted by the fire last weekend. The beloved members and friends and family members who are on our prayer list and in our hearts.
For small businesses.
For small businesses. For all who feel like they are hanging on by a thread. Serving as caregivers. And all who are struggling with illness.
The love of Jesus Christ and our salvation.
The love of Jesus Christ and our salvation. Place to gather in peace and worship. O God, you have called your servants to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths as yet untrodden, through perils unknown. Give us faith to go out with good courage, not knowing where we go, but only that your hand is leading us and your love supporting us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. I invite you to share a sign of peace with one.
Thank you. Yes, yes, inside.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because you put your hand on it.
Yeah.
So that's why it took me a second.
I see, but I don't think she recognized me. So
I did about 20 seconds later.
Yeah, okay. Like,
can
I just wait?
Like,
oh, it's just fine. It's like,
I was probably
supposed
to
be
asleep.
You guys probably both of us.
Yeah.
We will continue with our offering, and I need some helpers because I hear some coins out there. Dear God,
thank you for giving us everything we need.
Help us to use these gifts
to love and serve others
so that all may know
the goodness we have received
through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. A few announcements before we conclude our worship today. Common Council is tomorrow evening, with our individual councils meeting at 6 p.m. and then gathering together at 6:30. Our Wednesday evening worship continues this week at Faith with 5:30 p.m. Hold an evening prayer followed by soup. All are welcome to join us for a wonderful time of worship and fellowship together. Holy Week starts with Palm Sunday on March 24th. It's coming up quickly. Maundy Thursday at Faith at 6:30 p.m. on the 28th. Good Friday here at 6:30 p.m. on the 29th, and Easter morning here at 8:45 a.m. Easter lilies are orderable now. There is a sign-up sheet. I think there's a sign-up sheet up. Marita Watt is taking care of it, so talk to Marita if you have questions. In the side room. Awesome. And I think that's all of the things that I needed to highlight today. As always, there's lots in your bulletin, so be sure to check that out. Anything that I'm missing?
Rolls, coffee, and juice downstairs after the service.
Rolls, coffee, and juice downstairs after the service today. Thanks, Roy. Are there any milestones to share this morning? The big, the small, the in-between?
Got a new grandson.
A new grandson. Congratulations.
Maddox.
Yes.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Awesome.
Days ago, so on a Wednesday, North Wasika Church on the community, the Ministerial Association hosted a lunch, and a group of people, and I'm going to miss somebody, Cheryl, help me out, but Demarian, Char, Cheryl, Roy, Will, yes, I did, Will,
Diane
Fishbucker, and then last week we went, and Grace was having it, and there wasn't enough people, so in the kitchen with Roy again.
Oh.
Helping out again. So I think we should give those people, if I forgot somebody, we should give them thanks for representing.
A milestone for everyone who's been helping serve at those lunches. Milestone.
This Wednesday, Christ the Community is going to put on the Lenten lunch at on Wednesday.
Yeah, those lunches have been a wonderful opportunity to gather with the whole community, all of the churches in Wasika together. So if you haven't caught one yet, I encourage you to go there at noon on Wednesdays during Lent. And then the rest of the year, we do them once a month. So, any other milestones to share? Spotted multiple robins this week. That's a milestone. Very happy birthday, a milestone. See no more. I invite you to stand as we receive God's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Our ascending song is called Take My Life. I will teach it first. It goes like this. Holiness, holiness is what I long for. Holiness, holiness is what I long for. Holiness is what I need.
verse 2 together to the chorus, and then we'll sing verse 3 and 4 together, and then the chorus twice, and then the last line 3 times at the end. Thanks be to God.